Today, we're going to show you how bloggers make six figures without relying on Google AdSense. Welcome to Copy Hacks. Music machine, show me what you got. I'm Ange, and this is video 5 in our series, Brilliant Blogs. If you want your copywriting biz to grow, be sure to subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss out on another video. Today, we're talking about how bloggers make six figures without putting a single ad on their site. You've put the work in, you've created great blogs and have attracted a loyal audience, and everybody loves your writing, and you have $0 in the bank to show for it. Likes and shares are nice, but when you have mortgages and college funds and vacation plans, money usually pays for those more effectively. You might think that putting ads on your site is the only way to monetize, but there's a lot of potential downsides. They dilute your brand, they take up too much real estate on your page, they distract your reader, they kill conversions, they increase your load time, and maybe most importantly, they ruin your trust factor. When you've put all this time and effort into building equity with your audience, how can you generate revenue without selling them out? Cyn Meyer is here to help. Cyn is a writer at Podia, focused on creating actionable content to help creators earn income from their passions. Her 17 years experience in marketing means she's seen a lot of change. And while there may have been a time where AdSense made sense for monetizing your blog, these days, if you wanted to make $100,000 annually on your blog, you'd need about 20,000 visitors every day. So let's look at 5 other ways Cyn says bloggers can make 6 figures. First up is sponsored blog posts and product reviews. When you're looking to leverage your blog, you can look for companies that will pay you to either write a sponsored post about a relevant topic, including a link to their site, or review one of their products and services in your article. Just like Lou Martin, a pro blogger who runs Product Review Mom Blog, while raising 2 teen girls, she also does post reviews and makes anywhere from $200 to $500 per post review. And when you're blogging full-time, those numbers add up pretty fast. When you grow your audience, you also create niche markets that brands and organizations want a piece of. Lou recognizes this and even has audience demo info sorted out so potential ad partners can search for a match. And Lou's not the only one. John Lee Dumas's Entrepreneurs on Fire blog gets the largest portion of its revenue from sponsorship arrangements. Annabelle Candy charges over $700 for a sponsored blog post. Ryan Robinson charges $1,500 per sponsored post. As Cyn says, the better you are at promoting sponsored posts and the more consistent you are at churning them out, the better your paycheck will be. Cyn's second method is partnering up with affiliates. Just like sponsored posts, you're finding companies that are a match with your audience. But here, you're paid a commission every time one of your readers purchases their products from one of your blog links. This is a slippery slope, as you don't want to spam your own audience. But Cyn has the solution. If you want to keep your integrity high and your reputation unscathed, make sure your affiliate partner sells products and services that your audience actually cares about. Ask yourself honestly, will your audience benefit from your affiliate's offer? Maintaining the trust of your audience is key, and it's also a legal US requirement to disclose any affiliate links in your blog. Cyn uses a quote from Michelle Gardner's affiliate page as a great example, stating, "I may receive commissions for purchases made through links in this post, but these are all products I highly recommend. I won't put anything on this page that I haven't verified and/or personally used." For her part, Michelle attributes 63% of her August 2019 blog income to affiliates, and she pulls in over $100,000 a month blogging. In the US alone, retailers spend nearly $5.5 billion annually on affiliate marketing. So yeah, there's money to be had. And unlike paid ads, 76% of blog publishers say affiliate programs make monetizing super easy, and 45% claim it doesn't disrupt the user experience. So there are 2 ways to sell other people's stuff, but what about your own? Cyn suggests that you productize your expertise and sell a digital download on your site. It's not a giant time sink because you do most of the work on the front end. Once the file exists for sale, most of the work is done and you just have to maintain your marketing. There's a lot of different products you could make, like a how-to manual, Canva templates, even flashcards. No matter what you create, Cyn says it always needs one common theme. They make your target's lives easier. Just like your blog exists to solve people's problems, so should your digital download. As for pricing it, there's no hard and fast rules. Cyn says, get creative and offer something of value to your audience. See what they will and won't pay for it. If you've found that people really value your expertise, then maybe it's time to package it all up in the form of an online course. The market for e-learning is on fire right now, valued at $190 billion last year, and anticipated to grow beyond $300 billion by 2025. You're not greedy. You don't need all of it, just like a billion or two, right? If you need to figure out what to focus on, Cyn says choose a topic that combines your passion with your copywriting expertise and has profit potential. So stuff in here, don't do. But if you have something over here, go for it. Once you have a topic that excites you, validate, validate, validate. Check with your audience to see if the course topic is something they'd want to both learn and pay for. You don't have to interview every single person face to face. Use the internet to your advantage and post about it on social channels, DM people, email your list, run a poll or survey, make phone calls, engage in conversations on forums and groups, and a copy hacker's favorite, read Amazon reviews on that topic. Ryan Culp validated his idea on Twitter and sold over $20,000 in courses right out of the gate. And Michelle Gardner earned over $434,000 off a single online course. The more you grow in your blogging career, the more you can grow your income from online courses. According to The Blog Millionaire, pro bloggers that make over $25,000 in monthly income credit 80% of that income to online courses. But maybe you don't think you're enough of an expert for a whole course. Or maybe you don't have the time, energy, or resources to pull a project that big together. In that case, you can do exactly what Copyhackers did to start, and that's sell ebooks. The first four ebooks Copyhackers made brought in about $20,000 in 5 days and started our growth to a multi-7-figure business that just gives ebooks away. We're not the only ones. The global ebook market is expected to grow to over $14 billion in revenue in 2020. We've seen ebooks on everything from marketing for developers to cooking a vegan Italian Thanksgiving meal. Cyn recommends you either sell your ebook on your own site and keep all the profits, or sell it through Amazon, leverage their traffic, but be ready to give back some of your revenue as a result. If you commit to building an audience of loyal followers, there's a lot of great ways to leverage them to create additional revenue, all the while still giving them great value. Thanks for watching. If you're looking for more tips on how to write great blogs, be sure to click the subscribe button. New videos are added every single week. Click here to check out some more videos and drop us a line in the comments section. Let us know what you'd like to see us cover next on Copy Hacks by your very good friends at Copyhackers. And now, staring contest. 3, 2, 1, go. You win.